माई डियर किड्स वेलकम टू टुडेज मैथ सेशन एंड ए वेरी वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल एंड एनर्जेटिक गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल माई डियर स्प्लेंडिड किड्स ओके टुडे वी गोना कंटिन्यू विद अवर लास्ट लेसन लेसन 8 डेटा हैंडलिंग ओके लेसन 7 इज देयर सिमेट्री एंड ट्रांसलेशन दैट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड we gonna discuss in the next class okay guys are you clear the 7th lesson is there don't think ma'am is just left the lesson surely I will take next video next class next in the next class I will continue this lesson okay symmetry and translation okay today we gonna continue with our lesson 8 data handling okay guys are you clear this lesson is very simple as well as very interesting okay guys shall we go yes take a textbook page number 105 okay this lesson also we gonna continue doing all our exercise problem in the textbook itself okay guys are you ready yes here we go okay our takeoff section okay in this takeoff section so it's a work for you collect the details of the mode of transport being used by the students in your class to reach the school and fill the table as you wish you can fill okay how many of them came by bus how many of you came by auto car bike and others as you wish just please fill this okay guys just a simple homework for you try to finish this okay guys okay our next session is our first heading is data okay data please underline this guys the information collected in the form of numbers is called data please underline this my dear students okay the collected data can be represented in the form of bar graph or and pie chart okay so we here we gonna study about two section this is called as bar graph okay this is bar graph and this is pie chart okay so this lesson we gonna study those two section okay very interesting and very very simple okay guys okay first section is bar graph okay a bar graph can be drawn vertically or horizontally okay the height of the bars depends on the value of the categories they represent okay bar graphs are effective way to compare the given data okay it is very easy and effective method of comparing data first example survey of the students in a class is done to find which kind of movie they liked the most the data is recorded in the form of tabular column as shown okay type of movie comedy action family drama scientific and fiction number of students 4 5 6 1 and 4 here we go to compare with the bar graph and we want to answer the some question okay guys are you ready okay let's see the tabular column okay this is our tab this is our sorry this is our bar graph okay see here the number of students here type of movies okay here the type of movie first one is comedy 4 I'm right so see here just like graph okay number of students is 4 comedy so from the 4 draw a bar graph okay action is 5 I'm right 5 of them like the action so here it is number of students okay please guys please listen here in this axis this is y axis and this is x axis in this y axis there is 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 and 9 okay this side it is deals with comedy action family drama science and fiction okay type of movies okay here in the action contains 5 number of students okay 5 of them like this action movie so number of students is how much my here 5 yeah, along the 5 draw the bar just like a rectangle and color it okay next come to family so 6 of them like the family movie so 6 okay next one like drama so one column next science and fiction 4 so 4 column 1 2 3 4 column they are colored okay this is the way of drawing the bar graph okay now come to this session a bar graph is a good way to compare data we can see what type of movie is liked by the maximum number of students and what type of movie is liked by the minimum number of students at a glance okay maximum means most minimum means less okay now answer the following question based on this bar graph okay which type of movie was liked by the maximum number of students okay which is the greatest number here 6 am right yes 6 is the greatest number am right so The type of movie liked by the maximum number of students is 6. That is, 6 is family. Okay, 6 is in the bracket. So the type of movie liked by the maximum number of students is family movie. Okay, next, which type of movie was liked by the minimum number of students? Minimum means less. So less is here drama. I am right. So the answer is drama. Okay, next, which are the two type of movie liked by the same number of students? Okay, let's see which of them, which movie they like, which movie, which two types of movies are there, but the students liked the same number. Okay, here the comedy as well as this science and fiction, both 4 of them like this both, I'm right. So the answer is comedy and science and fiction are liked by the same number of students. Okay, the last one is, what is the total number of students surveyed? That is, the total number of students surveyed is, just add this numbers. Okay, 4, here it is 4. Next, for the action, how much, ma'am? 5. For this family, 6. Drama, 1. Fiction, 4. So just add this 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 1 plus 4. Just add, you will get the answer. That is the way of finding total number of students surveyed. Okay, are you clear, guys? Okay, dear kids, the exercise 8.1, the section 3, page number 109. This is just a homework for you. Very simple. Please do this homework alone, my dear kids. Okay, please do this homework alone. Okay, this is the only problem. So please do this. And after finishing, take a snapshot and send it to me. Okay, don't forget that. Okay, guys. Okay, guys, our next session is pie chart. Okay, so please underline this. Data collected can be represented in the form of pie chart. Okay, here the data collected can be represented in the form of pie chart. It is a circular chart in which the circle is divided into parts according to the data. Each part represents a part of the whole. Okay, so what is pie chart, ma? A circular chart in which data is represented by different parts of the circle. Okay, come to the example. Okay, please underline this line. Okay, guys, so in this section, data handling, we have 2 sections, bar graph and pie chart. Okay, very simple. Okay, here pie chart also very simple. Let's see the very first example. Okay, in a restaurant on a particular day between 7 p.m. to 8 p.m., a survey of customers' purchase is done and it is represented in the form of pie chart. Answer the following. Okay, so see, observe this pie chart and you're gonna answer this following question. Okay, so let's see the very first question. What is the favorite food among the customers? You want to find the favorite food among the customers. Okay, here by seeing the number, you can see the food that they like most. Okay, the food they like most. Here, burger 25, sandwich 7, pizza 13, cake 20, hot dog 30. So which is most here, my hot dog? Is hot dog is more, they liked more, I'm right. So what is the answer? What is the favorite food among the customers? The favorite food is hot dog. Okay, so write the answer here. It is hot dog. Okay, okay, our next question is, how many customers like cake? Okay, observe this. How many customers like cake, ma? 20. So the answer is 20. Okay, come, let's see the third C question. What is the least favorite food among the customer? Least means very less. Come to this pie chart. Very less number is here 7. The least number is 7. So 7, instead of, what is the food item given in the 7? Is sandwich. So the least favorite food among the customer is sandwich. So write the answer as sandwich. Okay, okay, how many customers like burger? So observe this and write, burger is 25. Okay, so instead of in this column, below the burger we have the number 25. So the answer is 25. Guys, are we feeling simple? Yes, you know, I know it's very simple, I'm right. Next, the E question. How many customers participated in the survey? As last we can see, I'm right. So if you want to find the total survey, what do you want to do? Just add the total numbers. Okay, So we can add here and write the answer in that column. Okay. First add hot dog 30. So 30. So first write 30 plus burger 25, sandwich 7, pizza 13, cake 20. Okay, just add this. This is the answer. Okay, so 0 plus 5. Whenever I'm doing such calculation, guys, please do along with me. Okay, 7 plus 5 plus 7 gives you is 12. 12 plus 3 is 15. So carry forward 1. 3 plus 1 4. 4 plus 2 6. 6 plus 1 7. 7 plus 2 is 9. So the answer is 95. Okay, guys. So what is the answer? So the answer is 95. Okay, guys, are you clear? Okay. So likewise, here one more example is here. Ramya has a total of 72 books. Look at the pie chart and calculate the number of each types of books. Okay, like this. Here total number of book is 72. Consider this circle. So the entire circle is 72. We gonna divide this. Okay. Number of comic book is half of the circle. See here. This is the entire circle. Comic book is half of the circle. I'm right. So half of the circle. So half into 72. Okay. 1 by 2 into 72. After cancelling, you will get the answer 36. Okay. Number of GK books means 1 by 4th. GK book is 1. This is half. I'm right. So 1 by 2. 1 by 4 means quarter. This quarter portion is GK book. So 1 by 4 into 72, which is equal to 18. Okay. Next two subjects are what, ma? This is half. 1 by 2. 1 by 4. These are the next portion. Next two portion. So this is one. This is 1 by 4. These two are 1 by 8. Okay. This portion is 1 by 2. This is 1 by 4. Here 1 by 8. This is 1 by 8. Okay. So 1 by 8 into 72 gives you 9. This is number 1 by 8 into 72 gives you 9. So number of subject books is 9. Okay. Number of story books is 9. Okay. So this is the another type of question deals with this regarding this pie chart section. Okay. Afterwards, you can write the answer, okay? Comic book. So you want to find the calculate the number of types of books. I'm right. So comic book, how much, ma? Comic books is 36. Okay. GK books is 18. Subject book 9. Story book 9. This is one of the type of pie chart. Okay. Okay, guys, are you clear? Okay, guys, this is a second homework for you. Please, this exercise 8.2, page number 112. Third question is a homework for you. Please do this, guys. Okay. Guys, are you clear? Please do this. It's a simple, very, very simple homework. Observe this pie chart and answer the question. So, today in this today video, I mentioned two homeworks in to both the exercises. Like, guys, please do this and take a snapshot and send to me. Okay, guys. Until, okay, thank you. Take care. Bye-bye. Whatever doubt you have, don't forget to call or text me. Okay, guys. Thank you. Bye-bye.